stuff. 3DS Direct, Old Man the Refund, Free Overwatch, Metroid Not Prime, Duke 3D 20th Birthday, Lohan vs GTA 5, and Kojima in the centre of the galaxy.
No, that's a guy joke. Or is it?
Dun, dun,
is it real?
Alright, microphone on. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's up really loud. Thanks for joining us for the musical interlude that I like doing, but...
Did you get to the centre of the galaxy ever? Pash, I know you stopped playing No Man's Sky, but... Watch the video on that.
Yeah. Watch that. Fucking hell. Thanks for playing. Fuck off.
Ramble on, episode...
76.
I'm Guy Sank, Absolute Jew.
Aaron Hughes, LL Stressio.
Stressio, he's still coming down.
I'm fucking still.
Saturday, yeah. Retro Games Night at the back game.
Sunday night, I was still kind of wound tight.
Were
you? Yeah, I really were. That's why all the Kickstarter stuff were pissing me off.
Well, yeah, check out Aaron's videos on Aaron's channel. He's done a Kickstarter thing, all these weird Kickstarter things, and he just looks at them and they're.
Yeah, strange. I'm going to start doing more videos on there because they're quick and I can just.
Yeah, he just shits about, can't you? Yeah, there you go.
It gives me something to do other than gaming.
Dill. Right. Abuse the news!
Oh, ponytail!
Ponytail. Right, so anybody watch that? That was good. I enjoyed it. It was usual shit, but you look for these little bits. And I think there was a couple.
Well, the 3DS Direct.
A couple of little bits that were interesting. And the rest of it felt a little bit like the usual chat that you'd expect.
Yeah, Nintendo.
So, this is the one I liked. There's a new Pikmin game for the 3DS.
All right, okay.
That's, when is that? 2017.
Let's teabagging Captain America. Sorry, I have to be done.
It's side-scrolling.
Right.
You little Olimar, I think it were him anyway, and you're throwing Pikmin at things, and I suppose you're solving little puzzles, so it's not your traditional Pikmin.
Yeah.
I don't know who's making it, actually. I don't know if Nintendo got someone else to do it or whatever, but I don't know, it looks alright. There's potential there. Certainly interested in that. Super Mario Maker on the 3DS. I don't think it has all the same amount of stuff.
No.
Well, I think it kind of does, but there's you can't do certain little things that might be annoying, like search for creative levels and a few other things.
Right.
But it's there. It's portable if you want to dick around. I kind of think it's best. I'd be more interested in that format,
yeah,
where I could sit on the bus and just be dicking around doing a level.
Yeah, but you're not a bus wanker though.
But I'm not a bus wanker. I need a driver.
yeah, don't we all?
Donate some money so
I can
get a driver.
I've got an idea for a Kickstarter that I might do.
Get me a driver?
No.
No. I've got a Kickstarter, get me a driver.
There's a theme, if you start watching those, there's a theme.
Is there?
They're all shit products, aren't they? They're all products you've got in your house.
I've noticed that much, yeah. Like the Polaroid one.
Polaroid camera, don't know, mind. But pillow.
There's a pillow?
There's a pillow. Yeah, I've done six of them.
Oh, I watched three of them. Right.
Yeah. Hat.
Right.
Fuck.
It's a turtle hat.
Yeah, it's just a hat.
These are all Kickstarter things, by the way.
So there's a hat, a pillow.
A pillow, right.
Right. A pencil.
Right.
A pencil. A knife.
Alright.
A knife.
Is it a special kind of knife?
No, it's just a knife.
There's not much more you can do to a knife, is
there? Yeah, but Gary's not even like aesthetically amazing or anything like that. It's just like,
just go to market, get a knife. Can he still do that, actually?
But the pillow's got like $1 million.
Wow.
You asked for 20 grand, you got $1 million. It's a fucking pillow.
That's fucked up.
You know what I mean? I'm deliberately choosing stupid, shitty, fucking ridiculous ones that have been funded.
That's not that
I'm going to have any kind of sway over people, whether they're going to pay onto it or not, but I'm doing ones that are already funded. For me, I say I'm allowed to mock that. But if it's somebody's like put loads of time and effort into something and it's not getting funded, I don't want to go aside.
No, no, it's just stupid shit, though.
It's stupid shit, yeah.
So we've got that. Yoshi's Woolly World is going on the 3DS.
So they've given up on Wii U, haven't they?
Yeah. That's dull, isn't it, really? And now I want all these on the NX, because Yoshi's Woolly World, it'll still be good. I mean, it looks good, but there was so much detail in that game.
Mm.
You need the wooliness for it to really pop.
Yeah.
I mean, you do get the 3DS balls, which I like, on the 2D ones anyway. You get some extra things like those little cute little videos you get with it and some extra levels. So there is extra stuff on the 3DS.
Right.
Probably not worth buying if you've already got it.
No.
There's an amiibo of the dog Poochie.
Poochie. Poochie Mama.
Poochie's cute.
Poochie's alright. Yeah.
But the amiibo, I don't like it. It's got a right big mouth and its tongue's hanging out. It's a woolly
still
one.
Still Porsche, yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah. Like Porsche, right. It's that style, like the Yoshi, so that's good. But I just, its mouth annoys me. So it doesn't, it's not as cute as it should be. Somewhat to do with Pokemon Sun and Moon, but just little bits of guff. Mario Sports Superstars. Do you know like Mario Tennis, Mario Golf?
Yeah.
It seems to have all these in one game, sort of. I don't think there's as deep as that. Horse racing, what else, what is there? Horse racing, baseball, tennis, golf, football. it's there. It exists. Animal Crossing New Leaf update. So if you like that, Ariane. But I don't know what the update is.
The update will be some new fucking skins or some shit.
I don't, but they've got a mini direct coming up with it. A mini direct just doing Animal Crossing New Leaf, which is pretty fucking old now, really.
It is, yeah. Well, yeah, there'll be something.
So, I don't know.
Whoop, there you
they
go.
Did mention a couple of things, but a lot of people love that game, so probably an excuse to jump back into it and fuck around some more if you've stopped.
I think that what they'll be doing is that I think they might be testing the popularity of it. I know that they always sell really well, do the Animal Crossing games, but I think they might be just...
See if they're still playing
testing
it.
Testing the water, yeah, just to see if people are still playing it.
They'll know, though, won't they? They'll know. They'll have some online data or something.
They might have, but a lot of people don't play it online, so they might have a reasonable amount online, but a lot of people might not be playing it online, so to see whether that sells well or... they'll see how many people download it. I think that might be a tester, and there might be one coming.
Maybe they've got one ready.
NX or something.
Can we chuck another one out?
Can we chuck another one out?
Yeah, the people still care. Okay, Mario Party Star Rush. So that's another Mario Party game. I mean, I've never really played them, but apparently they've been a little bit down, a lot downhill.
Yeah, they're all right on home consoles, because that's where the multiplayer, when you...
That seems to be the complaint. It's like nobody wants to play it on a 3DS. No, you want it on your TV.
You need it on
with
your TV.
Beer, yeah. Or you're with your family and you just want to fuck around.
Yeah, well, that's where they're coming handy. That's where they're fun.
All games like that are fun in that setup, yeah. But on your 3DS, I'm not so sure. It's same with that Mario Sports thing.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was thinking when you were saying it about...
If it was on the Wii U, it'd be more interesting, but... I mean, I still won't get it, but I could see the appeal for people.
Yeah.
But...
I can't imagine... I don't think I've ever had a sports game on any of my handhelds. Because of that, it's... I got FIFA 3 with my console, didn't I? And we had a few matches on that. But I could play that on my own, and know full well that if you pop round and you can see a quick game,
just
throw a joypad and we're away. But if it's on a handheld, it's I have to go through having to play online.
Mm.
I don't want that.
Yeah.
I'm not bothering. But obviously, I'm not the majority, because online gaming is huge, isn't it?
This is true. We're all stopping in our houses now. Tank Troopers, which is basically World of Tanks, but it's a downward shitty one. It's like a small one.
Right.
You drive around in little tanks,
right,
shooting each other. I don't know. It's a silly one. A few other shitey ones. There was some Wii U things. Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword is out now on Wii U eShop. But you can play that anywhere, putting the Wii game in. I'm not sure the point in that is. Is it cheaper?
Might be, but you'll be able to get it cheaper on now anyway.
And get it second on. No, they tend to still be fucking expensive.
Yeah, but if you've got stuff, you might be able to trade it in.
And also, Pikmin. Is
they're doing
the pointless announcements.
They're doing something like, Wii U.
I kind of
haven't forgotten about it.
Everything.
Well, you just why don't you just, instead of giving Wii U announcements now, start giving some solid facts on your NX.
Yeah,
start
that's what I was hoping now. For.
Start pushing it now. I mean, you've already mentioned that it's definitely going to come out.
Well, that's supposed to come out in March, so you need to be told about it now.
Yeah. Start pushing it now to really, really fucking big it up, to get that in people's minds more than Scorpio or Neo, which are going to be pushed like fuck soon. I mean, he's only a month away, 2 months.
Yeah, someone's going to shit all the money on that.
Yeah.
And then
like, why
by March,
they'll
be like,
get a Nintendo
I've already had my Christmas present, or I've treated myself to this. I'm not going to buy that.
That's it, because coming up in the next couple of months is PlayStation VR and PlayStation Neo and the Scorpio.
And games.
And games.
Everybody's going to be skint.
Then Nintendo are going to go, well, we've got a new console coming out in March, but we're not showing you, fuck all. I'm showing you Zelda and that's it.
I wonder if March is like a time where after Christmas, that's where like statistically everybody starts getting the money back.
Yeah,
you know, possibly. Like you paid off all your debts then.
Possibly, yeah.
So then there might be some reasoning behind this.
But still, you know, if you have just gone out and you spent £500 on a PlayStation Neo and the VR headset and all manner of peripherals and games,
that,
you'd be like, right, well, do I get a NX? Is it, how powerful is the NX? As powerful as a PlayStation, as an Xbox One, maybe. And you're like, right. No, I've got a PlayStation Neo, or I've got an Xbox Scorpio, which are now 10 times as powerful as the Xbox.
Well, they'll say everybody's portable bits, or something like that.
Yeah,
that's the thing.
But still, you know, it's like, why, if you're going down the portable route again, why are they pushing all this fucking 3DS stuff? Maybe they should go a little bit quiet on 3DS, and then start going, boom!
I think it's because most people just don't know. But a lot of them are just sort of remakes, apart from the Pikmin game, and that's 2017. And now I'd rather have that on an NX.
Well, they've got a new console coming out next year, and at the moment, I have no reason apart from mild interest into what they're going to do.
They did say that there's Pikmin 4. Hopefully that wasn't mixed up with this being Pikmin 4. But I don't think it were. I think Nintendo said Pikmin 4 is
done. Did they actually give a number?
Yeah. This was a while back.
Because technically that is the fourth Pikmin game.
Yeah, so when I heard this, I'm thinking, that's not Pikmin 4, is it? Because that's bullshit.
Possibly.
I hope it isn't. I hope they have Pikmin 4 done, ready for the NX launch, and then you've got, well, I can get this other Pikmin as
they
well.
They need to be promoting NX now, and they need to be showing games now. That Zelda game, as far as it does look quite interesting and quite nice, it's not good enough to get the Xbox One or the PlayStation owners to go out and buy it.
Yeah, because you're not getting all the other stuff, are you?
You're like,
Call of Duties and stuff, I assume. Unless they come out with all that.
Unless they come out and start saying that, you know.
That's not what you would buy it for.
Get this shit confirmed.
You want it all on one.
You're buying a Nintendo console for the Nintendo exclusives, but they're not showing us anything.
No, they've shown nothing.
So, right, what month are we on now? We're in 9th month. And basically, we've got Christmas coming up. If nothing gets shown by Christmas, then March is the release schedule. Does that mean they're going to drop everything in February? Or January, June?
Maybe they'll do it in
Gamescom.
You know when you're just depressed in January and it's all shit? They might do it then, try and get you excited.
But it's like one of those, like kids who are getting new consoles aren't the parents. If I were a parent, I'd be like, nah, mate, you've got this fucking thing here. You're making this work. I'm not buying you this other fucking console. Get a job. I'm only 12. Get a job.
Get a fucking job.
Never played Pikmin. Am I missing out? You are, actually.
It's really good. It's really good.
Yeah, a good pick-up-and-play game. You'll have to go for your tutorial at first, but after that, I played it in black and white originally, but it's very colour-orientated.
Yeah, Pikmin 1's really good. There's like a new player control one with the... It's better with the remotes.
Yeah, I played it with GameCube controller.
Yeah, and it's got a timer on it, but it's not annoying like Majora's Mask timer. It's good. And Pikmin 2 is...
Never played that one.
It's good, but they've got rid of the timer, so there's no stress there, if you prefer no timers. But there's all these extra little things that annoy me, like little caves and shit that you can go in, and I'm like, I don't want that, just give me the pure game, I don't need any bonus crap. And Pikmin 3 is back to basics. I don't think you got the timer, but it looks really good. But it's only on Wii U, so I assume you don't have a Wii U, because nobody has a Wii U.
No.
But if you do have a Wii U, definitely get Pikmin 3, because that is sweet. That's probably my favourite one, actually.
Right.
Just right length. They say it's short, but I thought, nah, I should say that. And then some more DLC for Hyrule Warriors for the Wii U and 3DS, which is... Phantom Hourglass and Spirit Tracks DLC packs.
Are they free?
That's out now. No, I think you have to... Oh, I assume you have to pay for these ones. And there's other stuff there for Zelda Land. Oh, maybe they are three. Are they three? I don't know.
Been a long time since a puzzle game, but it's hooked into me.
What about that new one? What's it called? That Wimbo one?
Inside?
Yeah.
That's meant to be very short.
Well, I fancy it though.
Yeah.
That's a puzzle game, isn't it?
Well, apparently half of it is and then the rest of it isn't.
Alright.
Yeah.
Try that.
Yeah. I think, is that not only on Xbox One though?
I think it's on PlayStation as well, isn't it?
PlayStation as well, yeah.
PC? Mm-hmm. Wii U works with Matt, Wii U? Yeah, get Pikmin 3.
Thanks.
Thanks. And there is new Legend of Zelda Amiibo for December. So there's a few of them. Which, yeah, that's good. And that was pretty much it. There was a few other little things. It was cringeworthy as usual to watch.
Yeah.
They're so child friendly when they do the stuff like.
Yeah.
It's weird. But because it's so weird, it's like what we were talking about earlier, you know, when they've got northernness.
Yeah. I could do,
like the song we were playing. I mean, if you're watching on Twitch, you know what we're on about. Yeah. If you're watching on YouTube, you don't. But we played Agadoo before it came on. And it's just this kind of shit like Peter Kay shittiness. I think Nintendo's kind of got that. It's all a little weird culture of shit.
Yeah.
But I like the shitness. I think that's partly what it is. Right, so that's the...
DS Direct.
3DS Direct. In other news... Overwatch is free this weekend, 9th of September.
That's PC only.
No, it's PlayStation 4, Xbox. I don't even think it's free on the PC actually. I didn't write PC. Maybe it's an oversight, but it's definitely on the consoles. Even if you, this is the fucking kick in the bollocks, though. This is the kick in the bollocks for the PlayStation. You don't need gold.
Network.
PlayStation Plus.
Yeah.
You don't need PlayStation Plus.
Right.
For Xbox, you need gold to get it for free.
Yeah.
I assumed you'd need the subscription basically for both consoles. Oh. But for some reason, for the Xbox one, for some reason, for the PlayStation one, you don't.
Mm.
So it's completely free.
Yeah.
Which is so much of a do on it. Yay! It's not Halo, it's not a game I care about.
Oh, fucking.
Well, I do care about Halo, but I do want to do on it. So, that's what I'm doing this weekend. Metroid, not Prime. So, I don't know if I mentioned it last week or if we read it in the Voice of the People.
Voice of the Hadoukens.
I can't remember, but. So, it did fucking shite in Japan.
Yeah,
it Nobody gave a fuck about it. And it's done even shitter in the UK. It hasn't even made the top 40.
I think they're losing goodwill. Quick.
The concern is still that Nintendo are going to go, see, nobody likes Metroid, and completely bin it. It's like, that's not Metroid, dickhead.
Yeah, I think...
And not many people buy Metroid anyway, even when it's good. So it's a difficult
one. If anything, they should take the sales of the pre-order and the sales of the Symphony of Blood or whatever it's called, that Castlevania game made by the original guy who made Castlevania.
Oh yeah.
Metroidvania, isn't it? So it's like, it's Castlevania-esque.
But they should have a look at all the downloads.
If you look at that, look at how well that got crowdfunded and people pre-ordered, and then look at all the downloads for Metroid, maybe that's where you should go from, because that Metroid game isn't a fucking Metroid game.
Yeah. No, it's not.
Metroid Force, is it called?
Federation Force.
Ah,
they should have just called it Federation Force.
Yeah.
They put Metroid on to try and sell more. Now, maybe it did give them a bump, but they've had such negativity from it, it wasn't worth the bump.
Yeah, it's like putting 6 at the end of Resident Evil 6.
Yeah.
If they just called it Resident Evil... and action queef.
Side mission queef.
Yeah, then it would have been alright to a degree.
Yeah, because then you think it's a spin-off and you can dismiss it if it's average.
Well, that's the thing with like Resident Evil Revelations. Because it didn't have a number on it, my expectations of it were it's not a proper Resident.
Well,
and I ended up enjoying it more. Now, if Revelations did have a number on it, I don't think I would have been... I would definitely enjoy it more than number 6, but... I don't think I would have enjoyed it as much.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah.
Like, ah,
you expect more, don't you?
This ain't a resi numbered resi game.
Yeah, and now Metroid, when you get Metroid, you expect a Metroid game either Prime or 2D.
Yeah.
Now this doesn't have a number, but that's just what you expect.
It is what you expect. And I think anybody reviewing that game should not be lambasted for reviewing it as a Metroid game and with their expectations thereof. You're like with using Resident Evil again as example. Resident Evil 6 got mixed reviews, and a lot of the reviewers reviewed it as the sixth in the Resident Evil series and really panned it down. Mm-hmm. Then other people were like, no, you shouldn't have to review it like that. You have to review it on its own merits, on its own game. But not when you've got a number or you've got a name attached to it, then there's certain things you expect of it.
Yeah, of course,
and you're meant to. I think you should.
I'd
hold
add marketing
that.
Hype to that as well.
Yeah.
And the hive mind of everybody just going, it's brilliant, even though you might not actually like it, you still play and go, yeah, it's brilliant, because everybody tells me it's brilliant, so it's brilliant.
It is, yeah, it is.
Is it really, though?
Is it? It looks a bit shit. But yeah, so Metroid Federation Force, it deserves all the horror it gets.
It's getting all that horror.
So.
It's getting it all. Duke Nukem! Remember that?
Yeah.
Not forever.
Just come here to kick ass and chew bubblegum.
Yeah, the proper Duke Nukem.
Bubblegum.
Duke Nukem 3D Remaster.
Big, the overweight me.
20th anniversary. So it's been re-released. It's got 8 new levels. They've added multiplayer, co-op, bot battles.
There were co-op in it anyway.
Were there? Mm. It's £15.
Fuck off.
And
fuck off.
It's he's redone the voice. I don't know if they've added any more.
John Cena.
He's gone back and he's done the voices again.
Of course, it's the only fucking job he's got.
Yeah, so he's probably happy. He probably did it for nothing.
I'll do it for nothing.
And yeah, that's happening.
Right.
It looks like they've cleaned it up a little bit.
I've got problems with this and big way. Big way. You ready for it? Ready for it?
Okay.
It's Duke Nukem 3D. Does not stand the test of time in any way, shape, or form. Doom original does.
It does,
it
yeah.
It still
Doom
does. Because it's flowing, it's flying. This Duke Nukem 3D at the time was really good because you had three-dimensional planes. You could get into elevators and stuff like that.
You had the pop culture.
And you had the pop culture aspects of it all on. And it was new and unique. Now we've got so many games out there that do all this pop culture thing better. Like your GTAs, for fuck's sake. You can go in first person in GTA and fucking murder.
I live there.
Then they keep releasing it. Re-releasing it and re-releasing, giving 8 new levels to a very fucking old game, and asking $15.99 for it.
Yes, they do.
Adding $15.99 as a price for it is just fucking ridiculous. It's stupid. Remember, there were a good one on a good Duke Nukem game on the. I want to say N64. It probably wasn't. It might have been game. Yeah, it was on N64. The one where it was third-person perspective.
Right.
And we went back in time, you ended up playing like Cowboy Duke and stuff like that. You were warping all the way around space-time.
I can't remember that.
Yeah, we had it on 64, but we had it for whatever console it was on.
Yeah.
And it was pretty good.
Yeah.
And it was like taking the thing of Duke and making it fucking 3D.
Right.
And it were all right. It was a bit different. And then you go back to play Duke Nukem 3D in first person, you're like, man, this doesn't stand the test of time. Yeah. It's fucking stupid hard. And it was one of the first games where you could actually look up and down in it. So that was
the
major thing. You can, like I say, Doom was always made on flat levels. Mm. You could go up steps, and you can only go... There was something to do with how you can make a level design in Doom, which was what blew game developers away, because it's actually all individual planes.
Weird, right?
It's very, very strange. Whereas in Duke Nukem 3D was the first proper 3D rendered world and stuff. So there's all your little aspects in there. Then, like I say, your pop culture shit. It doesn't stand the test of time. It doesn't stand the test of time at all. And then to ask $15.99 for a 20-year-old game, they call it 20-year-old. John St. John coming back and giving all his voice off. It's just, no, stop it.
Yeah, it'll go cheaper eventually, so that'll be...
Gearbox need to flop. I think Gearbox...
It is Gearbox,
dropping that out to try and make money, and they're horrible at that company. They should sell Duke Nukem off, to a small indie company, or even just farm it out to a small indie company and go, right, you've got as long as it takes for you to make a brand new Duke Nukem game.
Yeah.
You've got John St. John's on board, you make your own Duke Nukem game, and I think a smaller company might be able to come out, left to their own devices, with a not a completely new, fresh take on a first-person shooter one, but I think it'll be a little bit more humorous than that dog shite, that Gearbox shit out instead of
I'm going to hear some new comments, pop culture comments out of his mouth.
Just make him new.
I mean, maybe
take the piss out of SJWs.
Make
him the most meninistic person ever.
Yeah.
Or make him a feminist. Well, really spin him on his...
They've kind of made it look a little bit Donald Trumpy, so they have got that.
Right,
it does seem... maybe they're forcing that in, but
I mean, just flipping on his head, because he was at the time... He was your atypical fucking stupid popcorn action movie.
Well,
just flipping on his head, make him like caring and stuff like that. Duke Nukem! Advertise it like he's a big fucking burly man, but he just goes out for
women's rights
and shit like
you
that.
You could have a level like funny. That where he goes a bit strange, like he meets a woman or something and he goes a bit like... That'd be brilliant.
It'd be really funny, yeah. Some woman that's more masculine than him, like, puts him in his place. Just be fucked up, it'd be good. But yeah, with Duke Nukem, 20th anniversary, £16. Fuck off.
15, but that's
£15.
That's just going off, that's... They haven't said it's £15, it's just the American one is the budget price in America, whatever their budget price is, $20 I think. So they're assuming that it'll be the UK budget price, which is usually £15. So it might not be £15 as well.
Yeah, it's either way, you can get that on the Xbox 360.
Yeah.
And a lot of people bought that on the Xbox 360, and I've started noticing a little fucking trend that these companies are doing. Xbox One's got backwards compatibility. Great news.
Sometimes.
A major selling point for it. But
sometimes it has it.
Well, one of these companies are getting away with not giving you your right to access these old games that you've got because, hey, we got a new game coming out.
Yeah.
Duke Nukem 3D. So you spend $7.99 on it when it first came out on the 360, which was the new up-res graphics. It was Duke Nukem... Duke Nukem 3D HD, it was up-resed and everything, so it runs on your screen and away we go. So you spent $7.99 on that, so alright, cool, that sold quite well, we've got this property, let's ship this out, it's about 20 years. Yeah. So now you're going to charge us a budget price, so let's say it is £15, or even a tenner. I have to spend another tenner on this game. What the fuck?
Well, you had the same problem with Resi 4 that's just been released.
Resi 4 is just, I was going to get onto that. Immediately after this as well, but it is the same.
It's still relevant,
Resident Evil 4 has come out on Xbox One and PlayStation 4.
Yeah.
I don't know how much it is on the PlayStation 4. It's $15.99.
The Game of Champions.
$15.99 on the Xbox One. I nearly, because I don't want to use my card for it, I would play it and I'll go for it. I was in Tesco the other day and they sell. You can buy Microsoft money.
Points, yeah. Well, no, it's money now,
but you can buy it. But it goes in 5, 10, 15, 20. It's $15.99.
Oh, that's why they've done the 99.
Motherfuckers,
$15.99. So, if the budget price is £15, that works out okay, like Duke Nukem.
But
they had a penny on even.
Yeah.
You're fucked.
You have to buy £20 worth of credit.
Bastard.
Right, so he's like, that's costing £20 for somebody who wants to buy money for the child, which means you get more money off it. But not only that, the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One version of Resident Evil 4 is the same as your PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 version.
Which you have, the 360.
Which I own.
But you don't have.
I can't have it on my Xbox One because Capcom have released it on a disc, means that they don't have to do that.
Is that the clause,
it's a new game.
Yeah.
It's a new game.
It's not, but...
That's how they get away with it. It's a new game. So now what we're going to do is we'll re-release that. We can get some more.
So Xbox backwards compatibility...
It's being played.
It's being
played.
There's workarounds.
Well, they don't have to allow it. It's up to the game developer as to whether they allow that game to be open. So what would happen, I can imagine happening, is like Microsoft, not with all these games, don't get me wrong, but let's say for something like Duke Nukem, they were probably like, well, it is 20th year anniversary, what shall we do? Shall we release that other one that's gone? Oh, no, we've got these 8 new levels, one have been made recently. They're probably in a bin bag somewhere. Yes, they probably have got John St. John in, and because they have the source code for it all from the... the HD remake of what they did a few years ago, then that's all they're going to do. They're like, well, we've got that, so we need to up-res it. It is as simple as that, because all the texture packs are already up-res. So they just go, oh, just up-res it a little bit. I think it's a fuck you.
It's a jip. Stick with Duke Nukem Forever, confirmed.
Well good.
Lindsay Lohan versus GTA 5.
GTA 5th.
Oroken. So she was pissed off about unauthorised depiction of her in the game. I don't know, there's a woman who looks fit in a cartoon style that apparently looks like her.
Right, it's her from Front Cover and Red, yeah.
Yeah.
They've shown the model.
There's an
adult actress. Her.
Right. I mean, you can't. Anyway, so anyway, we can't decide because we're not judges.
No. I can't judge. I'm pretty.
Well, we can judge, but.
Yeah.
It doesn't have any effect because nobody listens to us.
Nobody
They should do. We should be gods. Self-appointed. But a five judge panel.
Right.
This is how much. And this has been going on for ages, hasn't it? I assume since GTA 5 came out, which was a lot.
I bet the first judge went, I'm making quite a bit of money off this case. I'm bored of it though. Gary, Judge Gary.
Judge Gary, don't trust Gary. He's dodgy.
Sit here, man, why? I'll make out that this is really hard to make a decision over. And Judge Gary would sat down and gone, wow, we can play this out. Let's go and get Billy Zane and fucking Captain America's left shoe. We'll get them in there. It's just, you don't need five judges to decide that.
It's going to be like GTA's Got Talent, and they're just sat there with buzzers, going, judge wrong. Anyway, so their decision was, no.
Ha!
Toss that.
Good.
What a fucking waste of time.
What an
obvious waste of time. People with money just bring up court cases, don't they?
Well, she doesn't have, that's the thing, she's been out of public eye, hasn't she?
Has she?
And she's just had all manner of shit, because she started complaining about this woman that you follow around one of the side missions, you know, the photographer missions.
Yeah.
And there's a starlet who likes to suck people off, and she's getting banged up the ass in one section, and you chase her down and stuff.
Yeah.
She complained about that at first, that's me, and it's like, is it?
Is it?
We didn't know you got banged up the ass and this, you know, what are you on about?
Yeah.
We just made this general
starlet. It's not our fault that you did exactly the same as this character, which you're now exposing.
Yeah, you're now exposing. then it was the, with her camera up, isn't it? Holding camera, red bikini on.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And she brought that up. She went, look, doesn't look like me. And if you, side by side, from what she reckons they look nothing like. And then, some guy who wasn't working at Rockstar, because Rockstar didn't give her any response, was like,
they get it all the time.
I'm bored of this. Yeah. Somebody else went, no, that's this model here. And it showed her, and she's an adult actress, a model, and you're like, this is a spitting image.
I bet there's quite a few, I'll just say thousands, women that look like that.
Yeah.
So if they all go to court, then what?
Then what?
Are they going to say, well, you looked on my Facebook profile and you took that? Just fuck off, everybody.
Everybody just fuck off. And I love the fact that I like the fact that 2K leave Rockstar to do their own thing, because Rockstar just got fucked.
Used to this shit there.
What's probably going to happen is this will be a mission in the next GTA.
Yeah.
You silly cunt.
Oh, yeah, that'll be a brilliant mission. Do that.
Pinsy Bohan.
Okay, let's quickly get through these. Yeah. Hitman will be on disc, so the new Hitman Season 1 on disc. 31st of January 2017. It will be £50 on console and £40 on PC. This is stupid. Right, so there's a new 3DS. Not new, like it's no different. You know, when you've just got a different colour, it's just one of them. Right. Get it if you want, it doesn't do anything different.
Right.
And it's called the, it's a Galaxy style, so I was thinking Mario Galaxy.
Woo!
But it's not, it's like literally a picture of a galaxy, you know, stars. That's happening. I wasn't going to mention this, but I think it was Nintendo Life. They went, it's strangely similar to this other one. Now you can get
skins.
Like a sort of a skin, yeah, that you sort of clip on, you sort of replace it. It's a third party one, and it's a Galaxy.
Right.
And I think it looks better.
Right.
And you can just clip it on. Now this was out way before this was announced.
Right.
And it's kind of what I felt when I saw, when they announced this, oh, you can get this new one with a shiny galaxy on now. It's like, so what?
Yeah, who gives
it's
10
a it's not even Nintendo related, it's just a galaxy. If it was Mario Galaxy, I'd be thinking, ooh, there might be a little Mario, they might be bringing out Mario Galaxy or something cool, whatever, but anyway, so you can get that for £16 instead of buying the 3DS.
Yeah, don't buy the 3DS.
Buy the 3DS thing.
£16.
Which I think looks better for £16. No, $16. Oh, so you're going to have to import it. You're probably like...
$8.
Stick a lot more money on that. Yeah, so you can do that. PlayStation Plus games. Are they out tomorrow? Tuesday. Yeah, I think they're out tomorrow. You get Journey, which is a good game. PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3. Lords of the Fallen, PS4. Is that the...
That's the...
Horde game.
Souls-alike. Dark Souls Lite. I've got it for Xbox One. I'm not good at them games.
I saw it for really cheap a while back and I didn't fancy it.
It looks nice. If there was an easy game mode...
Yeah. As soon as it was like Dark Souls, I was like, oh, fuck it then. But I did want it because I thought, it's a fiver.
It's alright. I just hate the fact that when I die or when I go somewhere else, regenerating enemies just fucking make me...
You're not getting your progression then. You don't feel like you're getting
it. Even Dark Souls ended up changing now. I think Dark Souls... 2 or 3, if you, Paul can correct me on this, if you you kill the same enemy 8 times in an area, you've gone.
All right.
So you can die.
Eventually.
Slowly progress.
Yeah, that's some of
it.
Prince of Persia, Forgotten Sands, PS3, Datura, PS3. Badland, Vita, PS4, PS3, and Amnesia Memories.
Ooh.
Amnesia Memories. Vita.
So, Amnesia's same, it's the scary horror walking around.
Yeah, well I figured that, so I assume is this some weird spin-off or is it just, is that the name of the game? I can't remember.
Alright, they got rid of it in number 3, Dark Souls 2. No Man's Skies, you can have refunds. If you bought that digitally on Steam, you can have refunds. If you bought it digitally for the PlayStation, you can have refunds. To this day.
Not even now.
To this day.
Even if you bought it on day one.
Because Hello Games are going to court. Somebody is suing the fuck out of them for misleading the public. Somebody's trying to sue Sony as well for it because Sony published the fucking thing. They're trying to proper sue the fuck out of them. So Steam went, if you own this game, you can have a refund, you're not allowed to download it again. Right, same with Sony, you have a refund.
But it's getting updates!
But the updates don't matter, you see, because everything is alive. When you sell a game...
Bollocks, isn't it?
I think this is where the line should be nicely drawn. They can use call it the No Man's Sky law, where if you promote something... And the game comes out without what you've said it was going to do. Not like a... Peter Molyneux selling an idea of a game. This motherfucker was saying, this is in the game. Yeah, Peter Molyneux used to say, imagine you can walk around with massive boner and put all your stuff on it, like a saddlebag. That would be cool. You're like, yeah, he said, imagine. Brilliant. So these are concepts. This motherfucker came out with distinct statements, actual statements.
You can watch YouTube compilations of all the bullshit he says.
All of it. And I watched one and I'm like, okay. And then I watched this other one where there was a guy playing the game and I think he'd already finished it. I mean, I know there's 18 quintillion levels, so maybe somewhere out there is like... But
maybe like, somewhere out there...
There's one level
it's a good
that
game.
Does everything.
Yeah, maybe somebody's having the time of their fucking life.
I don't know what everybody's complaining about. But yeah, so there was a guy who went through everything this dude has been saying. But he's been asked point blank, can you play online? Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course you can. Of course you can, but it's highly unlikely. Day one, bosh.
It's even on the boxes, that's the problem with the online thing.
So, see? Oh,
it's on the boxes. So it's been special. I think it was the special edition boxes of No Man's Sky. Yeah. It says online, right? Well, it doesn't, because they put a fucking sticker over it. But if you peel that sticker off...
It's on the box, then.
It says online.
It's on the box, then.
So that's how close it was to... It's not like some concept from way back.
Exactly. So, if you've got No Man's Sky digitally, you can get a refund from every place that you bought it. Which is good. Even Amazon, as well. Amazon are giving you your refunds. because that game is such a fucking crispy biscuit.
Crispy biscuit.
Crispy biscuit. Let's have a look at this. So we're going on to the new re-releases. I'll bang through these as quick as I can. Oh shit.
Oh, I tried to bear it then. Didn't work out.
Mother Russia bleeds!
Broken!
Today!
Today. Yeah, I watched a quick video on that. It looks fun.
Oh, yeah. That was the first developer I got in contact with to find if we, when we started this Show Me Games thing, they were the first developer, Dinnertation Games and Devolver Digital. I got in contact with them and said, look, will you keep me updated with this? I really, really want to. I'd like to promote this game. It's fucking... And they didn't get back to me because they're England cunts. So!
Yeah, I think it's getting the reviews of, like, gets a bit repetitive after a bit.
Yeah.
I haven't read many. But yeah, I mean, so like all of them sort of games, yeah. To be fair, Streets of Rage...
Four-player co-op.
...does that. But if you can co-op it local... It's fun because you're in the room with somebody else. Oh, it instantly knocks the score up.
We'll play it on stream.
Yeah, we can stream.
So Mother Russia Bleeds, that's coming out on a PC, Mac and Linux. The side-scrolling beat 'em up. Uber gory in a 16-bit style.
Angry Russians.
Angry Russians. Right, there's loads of smackheads and stuff in it. It just looks brilliant. That's out today. Also today there is Space Rangers Quest for the PC. I think that is a Sierra game. People who did King's Quest.
Oh, we need to keep an eye out for the best name as well.
Alright, okay.
The best name of a game.
So far, Mother Russia Bleeds is amazing.
Yeah.
Tomorrow we have Beyond Flesh and Blood, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, PC. And then. Sorry, I got birds. And then Wednesday we have Dogos for the PlayStation 4, Xbox One. Oh no, it's coming out on the PlayStation 4 on the 7th. But it will be coming out on Xbox One and PC at some point. Okay.
No, is it not the 6th of September on
PlayStation? Oh, right. Okay, yeah. See, he's the one with bad eyes. Yeah, so...
He's blurry, but I can see.
So Dogos is coming out on the 6th of September on the PlayStation 4, then the 7th of September for Xbox One and PC.
They have the release dates. And these are American ones, aren't they, as well? Yeah. They always release things on certain days, like it's always a Thursday or it's always a Monday, and PlayStation is different to Xbox. Yeah,
stupid. So Wednesday we've got Just Sing for the Xbox One, PlayStation 4.
What's that about, do you reckon?
I reckon it's about Michael Jackson's life in child abuse.
That'd be really funny if it went really dark.
Really dark.
Halfway through.
Just Sing. Ah, and you're a little starlet, and then all of a sudden producers get involved in what the fuck? Why am I in this dark room? Comes a quick time event to back to the shit.
Slapping away cops.
You know, like that action scene in Walking Dead where it's like they're coming towards you and then you look around these little items like press X to use a call for.
Yeah, yeah. Picking away other things.
Yeah, like fuck me, this went. I was just singing
sounds like a good game, though.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, play that. Quarry?
Queep?
Quarry. For Magic Library, PlayStation 4. The Legend of Heroes, Trials of Cold Steel 2, PlayStation 3 and Vita. Still making PlayStation 3 games. The Tomorrow Children, PlayStation 4. Swords. To Who Jensu Rondo Bullet Ballet. That's not bad.
Pretty good name.
Can't say it, but it's a pretty good name. PlayStation 4. And then we're on to Wednesday properly then. Awesome Nuts Assemble for Xbox One. Ocean Horn, Monster of Uncharted Seas, PlayStation 4. Unbox, a PC. Jotun Valhalla Edition coming out on the 8th for Wii U. That's a game to get. If you've got a Wii U, get that fucking thing.
Pikmin 3!
And Pikmin 3. Whoa, start your free trial today on Pornhub. Well, I'm doing a Pornhub thing, mate, so you may as well fuck off with your adverts. Jotun is also coming out on Xbox One and PlayStation 4 on the 9th of September. Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Spirit of Justice is on Friday. Steins Gate PC is on Friday. And King Oddball Xbox One on Saturday. So, yeah, go and get Jotun.
Name, game.
I like Mother Russia Bleeds.
Best name?
Do you prefer To Who, Jensen, Rondo, Bullet Ballet?
Oh, it's got to be Mother Russia Bleeds.
Mother Russia Bleeds.
There's so many period jokes in there.
Oh, yeah, of course.
So, that's a good one for me. I'll take that.
VOP time. Well, nice one, Ariane, for getting rid of that motherfucker.
Cheers. Whoever got rid of that, well done. That's fun, isn't it? Gone. Feel the power, you're like God. Right, so, voice of the people, I haven't done the picture, so we're gonna do a scroll and see what's crack-a-lacking. What is crack-a-lacking?
Oh, yeah. I'll give a shit, sorry.
I'm zooming in now. Do you wonder what my reactions are for?
Oh, what's going on there?
Douche!
That was incredible.
It's all been very incredible.
It is being very, very incredible. Okay.
Well, it's like extra guff at the top.
It is super guff shit. I have become Death, Destroyer of Worlds. I have become Queef, Stinky of Groin.
No, Squirtle's gone.
Squirtle is...
We murdered Squirtle last week. So, but if you've got any more fucked up pictures you'd like us to have there, send them to me.
That's mental. I don't know what's going on. It won't be a fucking Show Me Game stream unless something goes wrong. I do think you can go away, that one. Right. Weird. Weird biscuits. Right, one side. Let's just fuck around with this.
Just do a dance. Dance with me.
Whoa. I'm falling.
Don't dance.
You have no power over me. Power.
Well, that's even more fun.
Power over me.
We never end.
You have no power. Oh. You have no power over me. I saw you standing there, creeping your pants. You have no power over me.
We don't have Squirtle, but we have Infinity.
Whoa.
Yes.
Oh, exactly. Little dots.
Oh yeah, there is the Master Sword Vibrator. I'm sure that'll be coming up somewhere.
There we go. We'll put that up there. I quite like that.
Right, we're having that. Put minute.
Put minute. I'm just liking it.
Who's took a lot of drugs before this, so this is...
I have, I've been taking...
10 times more amazing for him than it is for me.
Right, okay. Monitor capture. Propertates. There you go, you've seen the background.
Drink.
There we go. Oh, we're back to normal. You have no power over me.
Okay, voice of the Beagles. Nice. What's happening? There was a lovely picture of Graham Daly on here somewhere. We need to see that at some point.
was miraculous.
That'll be coming up. Coming up, picture of Graham Daly.
It was down on Saturday night with that very, very same hat on. Yes.
Oh, you'll see that. That's worth the wait. What's he saying? I can't even read that. Anyway.
Would any of you do a games night outside of Retro Games Night?
Carry on.
Deep questions from a deep mind.
So we've got Sonic Mania. There's 12 minutes of that. No. I watched it. It looks like Sonic. But they've changed the Infinity music.
Right. He said that they always changed it.
Maybe they do.
They didn't particularly.
It
was a retake of the original Infinity tune because it's the same thing, so it'll be slightly judged up. But it's a completely different fucking tune on that one.
I don't like it. Gavin Edgerton was saying they take the theme of the game, like the intro theme, and then that's your invincibility music.
Oh.
Which it probably is, I don't know.
But when
I'm looking at Green Hill Zone,
yeah,
which you're like, oh, nostalgia, bloody, bloody, blah. And then the Infinity comes on, and it's this other tune that I actually find quite jarring anyway, but I find it more jarring because I'm expecting the traditional, classic Infinity tune.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Just a minor gripe.
It was.
It annoyed me. It'd be like changing the coin sounds or something, the ring sounds. I don't know, it just sounded
weird. It was a rehash of the theme, but it wasn't a rehash of every single individual's game's theme. Because if you play Sonic Adventure, the original one for the Dreamcast, and you got it, it was the original Sonic theme sped up. Which is the Infinity
tune. What you'd expect, whatever it is,
So,
anyway, it's just a little thing, but that confused me. Oh, this is Mother Russia Bleeds.
I'll get rid of sound, right.
Which is one of them types of games. So
yeah!
Assume, if it's local co-op, then get your buddy around.
It is four player local co-op.
Get your buddy around and do that.
That bum there, he's one of the characters there. He's smacking fuck out of him. I think he uses broken pill bottles as knuckle dusters.
It probably does get quite boring if you're playing on your own, maybe, after a while. Depending on how long the game is.
All them people took pigs.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty... Yeah.
Grim, it's dark, it's brilliant.
You wait for the next level to look weirder and the next stage just sort of fucks up. I'd enjoy playing that.
Oh yeah. I don't know whether my laptop will be able to handle two player on it, but I'm streaming, but we'll give it a go.
Can you not get it on console?
No, it's PC only.
Fuck a duck.
You probably end up coming out on PlayStation because PlayStation sort of picked these games up.
Yeah.
It's not like Miami never came out on Xbox. Which is just fucking stupid, in my opinion. But
great music.
Yeah, very good music.
Right, what else have we got? So what's this?
You shared it. Video games and their advantages. Video games prepare people to make decisions faster. They also improve creativity and imagination. They improve coordination and eye, and the ability to drive in foggy weather.
No, I don't get that.
You said
N64 maybe.
Yeah, but still. People that play video games make decisions 25% faster. You've already said that, so people who play video games repeat themselves. And I do. And they can also focus on six things at a time without confusing them, and they develop the capacity to solve several problems in different situations. Yeah, but what it doesn't mention there is we have to go back and forth for everything we do. We're making a brew, we have to go to the shop, buy the milk, come home, and then be sent on a because our inventory is only one slot.
Yeah.
So we always have to pick up everything, and so it's always back and forth. Basically, our lives as gamers turns into a over
OCD lands.
Resident Evil 4 puzzle.
But no, it is proven that games do improve your cognitive skills and a lot of other things, so it's based on that, I assume.
Johnny Floyd, roses are red, soldiers are nervous. You have lost connection to the EA servers. It's a World War One thing. I can't pop it up over the top.
I'll join you.
Yeah, look at this.
What's up?
I like this. This was quite funny. Shared this again. I'd like it to start without the audio. Wee! I'm a gamer. I break games.
Now imagine if a plane was coming past now and you're just fucking.
Yeah, the guy.
Fuck you, buddy.
What you get for flying planes, motherfucker.
I love glitches. If they ruin your game, it's bad. Like deletes your saves or whatever. Yeah. But if it's so stupid, you just buzz your tits off, don't you? You're like, fucking hell, I'm going to keep this going.
No, it's only in gaming where you will be running around a battlefield and stop and go, how's he got up there?
Yes, yeah, so it's just flying.
What the fuck, man, is it?
I'm going to have to kill him.
Retro Games Night at the Batcave happened at the weekend.
That happened.
That fucking certainly happened. I've got PTSD, post-traumatic stream disorder from it. Oh, look, Melody's shared this.
Ironic, because he's been on before. It has. But
by the same person. Was it?
Yes. Really? Have you shared this twice?
Yes.
About memory.
Yeah. Gaming helps your cognitive skills.
Here's the guilty party, I think.
Real life Nuketown.
Yes, you can do paintball in Nuketown. Who shared this?
Melody.
Melody. Nuketown. Yeah, so that's good.
Final station.
I said final solution then. Moving on. So this is...
Bollocks, apparently.
Bollocks, but was it on Pornhub or something?
Yeah, we're on Pornhub, just like the guy who just turned trotted up earlier on that.
Yeah, yeah.
Final solution.
So he says it was on like a Twitch stream, but it wasn't. No, it was on Pornhub, but still quite funny. She's basically shagging a master sword.
Nice.
Can't argue with that.
And why not?
Already done it. Oh, this is great.
I can't see it.
No, that's why I put it on, because I knew this would be happening.
Right.
So for some reason the attachment...
Oh, fuck, yeah, this is brilliant. This is brilliant.
Like Doom, new Doom mod.
Let me pause this quickly.
So everybody download this now. If you remember this series, what was it? Home Improvements.
Bow, bow, bow. Yeah.
I used to watch it all the time. It was great. I thought, what's going on? This is the menu screen. It's not irritating at all. You can play this for hours and not be irritated.
Oh no, clearly. Oh, I want to play it in VR.
Kill myself. Oh. Can you imagine if it was you, like your old face everywhere? Well, it'd be freaking fuck. So, yeah, do that. Play that. That's fun. What else have we got?
What else? Moving on.
Moving on. Oh?
There's one since you had a video of the Retro Games Night at Tabath Cave, so you can have a look at that right now. I'll turn that down because it's going to go out. So this is what happened on the weekend. This is that was King of Fighters 14.
Yeah, so if you've never been to the Bat Cave,
get fucking down there, man.
This is a little bit of it. It's basically loads of retro consoles you can play. The Bat Cave actually is like a comic book.
It's a comic book.
Once a month, Lewis from Gamer does a retro games night, which Aaron streams from. Show me games, Starly. And
with help from Liam and Jack Taylor.
Yes, you can watch that video as well on the tubes. And you just play a lot of old games and stuff. Was it £3? He's doing something weird, you've got to tell me.
It's £3 to get in there from 5 o'clock till 9 o'clock, so you've got a good 4 hours of gaming. It's good, there's snacks, there's drinks and snacks, and there's loads of games consoles. There was a speed challenge, which was the sliding level from N64 Super Mario. There's that sliding.
I mean, all the stars in that game.
All the stars. And then I set a high score on this very shooting game here. Yeah. Right? There's my name before. I'm actually sat there setting the new score.
Yeah, I think we were getting a lovely shot of your face.
You get it right now, actually. I set the high score on that game as well. You should circle back
show
to
me game, show me games.
That's what was happening. The games that were being shown. And that was King of Fighters 14. Now it looks like an absolutely beautiful game, but none of the participants that turned up knew how to play the fucking thing. Oh, there I am.
How sexy am I? Now watch him die.
Yeah, do I die? Get out of my nose.
The pressure was too much.
I did end up setting a high score there, and then Sean Holly from the Tenpence Arcade. My high score on that was 1.8 million, which beat Lewis's score because Lewis were at top. Then Sean Holly turned up, and I said, I'll set a high score on that. And he went, all right, fair enough. I had a play with it. I said, how did you do? He said, yeah, all right. I said, did you beat my score? He went, oh, yeah.
Of course,
how much? 6 million.
He plays super retro games. They're hard.
I watched him then. I think it was Justice Elite or something like that. Judgment Elite or something. And then there was a sequel on there. So he got Lewis to put the sequel on. And he went round the game.
Wow.
Because the game goes on, you finish it, and then it just goes, well, I'll the first level again, but we'll make it more difficult.
Right.
It's like, fucking.
See, there's your hand-eye coordination.
There you go, yeah. And that guy's in his 90s. It's not. Good guy, Sean Holly. He did all right in the tournament as well.
Cool. You can check that. That'll be out. You can do that again next month.
Yeah.
You do that.
Yeah.
No! This is it! Graham Daly!
I'm going to leave that. I think we should call it there. For
can we have that picture there?
Yeah, I'm going to...
Forever. We found Squirtle's replacement. I'm sure he'll be fine with that.
Oh, he has no choice.
Right. I don't know. Let us know, Graham, if you're not happy with having your picture there.
He doesn't watch this. Nobody watches this.
Yeah, I'm coming
this.
Now.
All right,
yeah. Oi, classy. We're just saving that photo for future reference. You can shrink it and put it on. Put it on Hulk's head.
I'm going to paint it in green.
You got me. I'm going to cut that out.
And yeah. Or I might just put it there. I'll cut it.
You can put it on one of the ladies.
Oh, no, you'll love that. Oh, no, he's best off going on Thor, isn't he? At the next page.
Yeah.
Because he's touching.
Yeah, anyway, right, okay, talking about the next page.
Here we go. That's why. Well, hold on. All right. How's it going? Thanks for watching. Click like and subscribe. Patreon. Thanks to all those people who support us on Patreon. And see you in a bit.
See you later, guys. Thanks for chatting.
Oh, yeah, there's that as well. Where are you?
That. There.